just as you are to worship. Come, just as you are before your God. Come.
One day every tongue will confess you are God. One day.
The time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your heart. Oh, come, just as you are to worship. Come, just as you are.
Hello there, everyone. Welcome to our first collective worship in the month of October. It's lovely to see you all again. I wonder if any of you have watched our online church Harvest Festival yet. You'll find it on the NCK website. The service took the form of a walk, and you might recognise some of the places where it was filmed. You might even take your family on the walk the next time there's a sunny day at the weekend. Just download the service sheet to use as a guide. Now, are you all set for our worship? Have you got your candle ready? Let's begin. The Lord be with you, and also with you. We light our candle to remind us that Jesus is the light of the world. Let us remember why we're gathered here. Loving God, we're here to worship you, to sing your praise, to listen to your word, and to pray to you in faith. Let us say together all that we believe. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God, the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. you remember the name of the person whose letters we've been hearing about so far in collective worship this term? Yes, Paul. We've been hearing short passages from Paul's letters, which are full of tips for living in a good way, a way pleasing to God. And this week, the children from Norley School are going to tell us how Paul saw life as a kind of race, with a prize we might win.
Reaching for the goals. Paul's letter to the Philippians. My friends, I don't feel that I have already arrived, but I forget what's behind, and I struggle for what is ahead. I run towards the goal so that I can win the prize of being called to heaven. This is the prize that God offers because of what Christ Jesus has done.
Hi everyone, it's Reverend Andrew here. It seems like such a long time since I was last with you at Norley School. And in fact, if you're in reception class, I don't think we've ever met before. So it's really lovely to meet you and to be with you in collective worship once again. Now, I know that over the last couple of weeks, you've been looking at one of St. Paul's letters that we find in the New Testament of the Bible. And that letter is called Philippians, or the letter to the Philippians. Now, the reason why it's called Philippians is because it was written to people who lived in a city called Philippi. And just as if, just in the same way that if you are from Britain, then you are called British, or if you're from England, then you are called English. So if you are from Philippi, then you are called the Philippians. And that's why the letter is called Philippians. Now, Philippi was an ancient city. It's not quite there in the same way anymore. There's another more modern city which is near where the ancient city of Philippi was. But I'm going to show you where it was now. And to do that, we're going to fly up from our school. There's our school there, Norley School, and our school field just there. We're going to zoom up into outer space so that we can see the whole of our country, the United Kingdom. But of course the story isn't from the United Kingdom, it's from the ancient world and the Mediterranean world. So we're going to zoom down to this big sea called the Mediterranean, and there is the Holy Land of Israel, Palestine, where Jerusalem and Galilee was, and that's where the stories of Jesus took place. But to get to Philippi, we've got to go back across the Mediterranean, over this country here, which is what we now call Turkey, flying over Turkey and into the modern country of Greece, and then zoom down, fly over these mountains there, and eventually we get to the city of Philippi. And there you can see the amphitheatre there. We're going to spin round so we can see the rest of the city. Zooming around now, and here we go. Yeah, ka-chung. And there we see the city of Philippi with its amphitheatre there. And that's where it was. Okay, now I'm going to, let's have a look at this. Yep, okay, and here's an artist having a go at what Philippi would have looked like at the time of St. Paul. Now, when St. Paul first visited the city of Philippi and told the Philippians all about the love of Jesus, not everyone liked it. So much so that they took Paul and his friend Silas and they threw them both in prison. But Paul wouldn't stop talking to people about how much God loves them in Jesus. And eventually, as he kept telling them over and over again, he started to make friends, including with a local businesswoman who was called Lydia. And together, Paul, Silas and Lydia helped to set up a church that worshipped Jesus in the city of Philippi. Now, Paul was very proud of the church in Philippi. In fact, when he wrote to them a bit later on in the letter, he says, you Philippians, you are my joy and my crown. It means I love you very much and I'm very, very proud of you. And he's proud of them because just as when Paul was with them, so he told people about the love of Jesus. So now the Philippians were starting to do the same thing. They were telling their friends and their neighbours about how much God in Jesus Christ loves them. And that meant that they were starting to get in trouble as well, because people didn't like that message. And so Paul writes his letter to try to encourage them. And he says, you know, following Jesus and living our lives in the way that God would ask us to live our lives is a bit like running a really hard race. It can feel really difficult sometimes when it feels like the race is never ending and we're having a bit of a tough time. Now, you might remember, some of you older ones might remember, that about a year ago I came and we talked about a really long race that people run called marathons. And marathons are 26 miles long. And when I was with you, I asked you this question, actually. I said, how many laps of the Norley school field do you think you'd have to run the 26 miles of a marathon? And we did the calculations, if you remember. So here they are. So I drew a line around our school field here, line around the edge of something that's called a perimeter, isn't it, I think? That's right, yeah. Okay, and I measured it, and it's 0.1 miles. And some of you older ones will know, well, if it's 0.1 miles for one lap, then you'd have to run 10 laps to run 1 mile. And to run 26 laps, it would be 26 times 10, which is 260. So if you want to run a marathon around your school field, you'd have to run around the school field 260 times. Wow, I think. Well, I know that when I was at school, I was much better at short fast races than I was at longer ones, and I get if I had to run a long race, I get a little bit out of puff. But I had a wonderful teacher who used to encourage me and would say, oh Andrew, keep going, I know you can do it, I know it's hard, but keep going and you'll get there. And eventually I would finish the race and get to the end of the race like everyone else. And that's what St. Paul is saying, actually, about our life with Jesus. Sometimes things are really, really tough. In our school at the moment, we've got to follow all these new rules that we're still getting used to. We've got to stay in our bubbles, and we can't see everyone in the way that we would like, and we can't have collective worship in the same way we would normally do. We're watching the telly instead, and everything's a little bit different and a little bit difficult, isn't it? And so on. And Paul says, well, that's a bit like our life with Jesus. Sometimes it can feel really tough. But remember, says St. Paul, that God is with us in it. God sends God's Holy Spirit to encourage us and to be with us. And then not only that, but, says St. Paul, even though we've not finished the race yet, God in Jesus has already finished the race. And he has won the prize and won the race for us. So that means that even though we're still running the race, actually we can know that the race is already won. Now, I think that's really complicated. And if you're old like me, it's still complicated, but it's those two things. One is that God is with us in the race and helping us and encouraging us. But at the same time, God has already won the race and won it for us, and he's waiting for us at the finish line. And when we get to the finish line, God in Jesus is going to look at each one of us and say, I knew you could do it. I knew all along you could do it. And here's the medal. You get the winner's medal because I've won it for you. And that's just, it's really, really difficult to understand, but it's really wonderful. And Paul wrote his letter called Philippians to try to get the Philippians to understand that that's true. God is with us every step of the way. And St. Paul himself, St. Paul is like their teacher. He's the one that they all look up to. And Paul says, not even I have finished the race yet, and I'm still running to try to get to the finish line, and I know that God in Jesus will be there to welcome me home. So we're going to sing a song now, and it's a song that I've sung with you before in school, but it was a long time ago. And the words just repeat. There's only two lines, really. And the first one's this one here, and it goes, come with me, for the journey is long. Come with me, for the journey is long. And then the second bit is, the journey, the journey, the journey is long. The journey, the journey, the journey is long. Now, I know that we're not allowed to sing in school at the moment. We can't sing in church at the moment, sadly. But maybe you're allowed to hum, and your teacher will nod or shake their head about whether you're allowed to hum or not. So I'm going to sing that for you, and there's a little video for us to watch together.
Come with me, for the journey is long. 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 The journey, 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 journey is long. Come with me, for the 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 journey is long. The journey, 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 journey is long. Come with me, for the 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 journey is long.
Amen. So remember those two things, folks. Remember, first of all, that God is with us every step of the way, even when life seems difficult, to help us and to encourage us. And secondly, that God in Jesus has already won the race and waits to greet us and to welcome us home and to say, I knew you could do it. So friends, as you go forward into this school day, make sure that you keep encouraging one another to keep running the race and keep going and keep trying, and know that God is with you every step of the way. May God bless you all. Amen.
Thank you, Andrew. And now the children from Norley School are going to lead us in our prayers.
Lord God, we know that sometimes people have very hard things to cope with in their lives. We pray for the lonely, people who do not have enough to eat, people who are sick, people who don't have a job, people who are poor. Sometimes it's so hard for them to carry on. Please help them, Lord. Amen.
Dear God, we have many goals in our life: to pass our exams, to get a good job, be like our favourite celebrity, have nice things. But we know that having you in our lives is the only true goal. Help us to see our lives as you do. Amen.
Let's bring all our separate prayers together now in the prayer that Jesus taught us. We'll say the words together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. May God keep us as we work and as we play, as we think and as we act, as we listen and as we talk. And may he hold us in the palm of his hand. And the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Next week, Hilary will be with you to lead collective worship. I'll see you again in a couple of weeks' time. I wonder how far you'll have moved towards Jesus by then.
In my wrestling and in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence, you won't let go. In the questions, your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, my lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. Oh, my lighthouse, my lighthouse, I will trust the promise, you will carry me safe to shore. Troubled sea, whoa, you are the peace in my trouble.